Hello everyone, welcome to the community talk with Nihantra. Today we will learn how to fetch data from one DocType to another DocType. I have seen a lot of users having this issue in the Frappe Forum. So let's explore it and learn about it. So go to the DocType list. Here you can see that I already created a child data, that name is the invoice item. Here I created a field because we have to get the sales invoice data. Also created a doc type whose name is invoice data. Here you can see that I have added a invoice item that we have seen recently in this table. First we will learn to fetch the data with the default feature. So we have to create a field, so set the label name like sales invoice ID, set the option sales invoice. Now we have to fetch the customer from the sales invoice ID, but the sales invoice ID does not. So let's set the option customer. Here you can see sales invoice ID does not show in the fetch from. So first you have to save the doc type because sales invoice ID is not created. Now again check the fetch from list. Here you can see the sales invoice IDs appear, so select it and select the customer and save it. Also we have to create the invoice date. We will get the date from the sales invoice ID just like the customer got date and save the doc type. Also we have to fetch from is set for the company. Select company and save the doc type. Open the invoice data doc type, reload the page. Let's select the sales invoice ID. So you can see the details coming properly, but you can't get item details using the fetch from feature. So let's create the client script. We have to get sales invoice details, so select the doc type like invoice data and enable the script. Sometimes users say how to get master and parents level transaction data at parents doc type and child doc type. So first we have to remove the fetch from condition from the customer, invoice date and the company. Save the doc type, go to the invoice data and test the data is coming or not. So it's not coming. Now we get the customer invoice date and company from the sales invoice using the client script. So we use frappe.db.getValue. The sales invoice we have to also add the filter. We have to get from dot doc dot sales invoice ID. We have to get the value from the sales invoice. So set the invoice field name that we want. Customer open the sales invoice to check the field name. Copy the posting date. Also, we have to add the company. Function of value. Now we have to use the from.set value. Customer value.customer. Copy the line. Paste it. Invoice date. Value dot posting date. Company. Value dot company. Set the event. Reload the page and check the output. Select the ID. So here you can see the customer invoice date and company is coming properly according to the ID. But again, child table data is not coming. We cannot set the child table data using the frappe.db.get value. So now we have to use the frappe.call. But we have to first define the condition if from doc.salesinvoice ID. From frappe.call. Now we have to enter the method like frappe.client.get. Set the argues. DocType. Sales invoice. Filter. Because we have to set the filter because we want to get the invoice detail according to the sales invoice ID. Set the callback. We have to apply the condition like if r.message. Now added a console log for the testing. Reload the page and check the output. Open the console. Select the ID. So you can see the whole sales invoice details coming in properly. Now set the panels value from dot set value. r.message.customer. Copy this line. paste it. Invoice date, r.message.postingDate, company, r.message.company. Let's reload the page and check the value. So value is coming properly. Now we get the sales invoice table detail and set them in the invoice item table. So we have to set the for loop r.message.items for each function item. Now we have to add the data in child table to use the from.addChild. So copy the field name, now child.itemCode is equal to, also copy the field name from the sales invoice item table. Let's copy that, paste it. Now we have to add the refresh field. Copy the field name, paste it. And save it. Reload the page and select the ID. So here you can see the value added successfully in the child table. Let's select the another one. So it's coming properly, but problem is that as many times as you select any invoice ID, it keeps adding value. So delete all row from the child table. So we have to use something like from.clearTable. Copy the table name, invoice item. Let's configure the another field in code. Just copy the line and paste it. QTY UOM rate. We have to add more one row for the amount. Let's reload the page and check the final output. Select the ID. So here you can see the all value were successfully added in the child table. Here you can see invoice according item is coming properly. Let's select another one. Let's open the sales invoice ID for the cross testing. It's coming properly. Thanks for the watching. If you enjoy the video, please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to leave a comment below. Thank you.